parents in Christ, we are going to go through the stations of the cross with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He has called us into this journey with Him, and because we are here with Him, we shall be blessed. He is going to bless us in a special way. It is time to look unto Jesus. He has called us, and He who calls us will also justify us in the name of Jesus. The Bible tells us that God will never despise His children. He will never despise those who put their trust in Him. Because we put our trust in Him, it is well with us in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. The Bible says in Romans 8, verse 30, for those whom He predestined, He justified. And on those whom He justified, He will also glorify. I pray that this night, may He justify us and may He glorify us in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, be thou glorified, even in our prayer tonight. Take over, O Lord. Every monitoring spirit, we cancel them completely tonight. We declare the prayer a fire zone in Jesus' name. Amen. My dear friends in Christ, as we go through the sessions of the cross, we are going to pour our hearts to the Lord. We are going to ask Him to bless us, to help us to have total commitment to the things of God, to walk together with Him, to repent fully and accept Him as our Lord and Savior, and that above all, to carry our cross obediently and follow Him. This is the purpose of this prayer tonight, a journey with Jesus, a pilgrimage with Jesus, a trip with Jesus. So we're not alone here, we're with Him. And He knows that this is an hour we have a station on the cross with Him. So He comes to be with us. Amos chapter 3 verse 3 says, can two walk together except they be agreed? So Father, we thank You as You have honored this hour with You. May it be an hour of repentance. Let it be an hour that to bring glory to Your name. Let it be an hour that to help us to follow You and follow Your footsteps. Let it be an hour that to miracles will locate Your children, that those who are sick shall be healed, and those who are tormented by the spirit of the devil shall also be delivered. We give You all the glory. And so we hand over this prayer of this night to You, that You may take over, O Lord. Blessed be Your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
We give You all the glory. We give You honor. We give You all the glory. We give You all the honor. We give You all the glory. We give You all the honor. We give You all the glory. We give You all the honor. Amen.
The Bible says in Matthew chapter 26, verse 36 to 39, and Jesus came with the disciples to a country place called Gethsemane. And He said to them, sit down here while I go over yonder to pray. And then when He took with Him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, and He began to be saddened and exceedingly troubled. And He said to them, my soul is sad, even unto death. Wait here and watch with me. He went forward a little, and falling prostrate, He prayed. Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass away from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will. My dear people of God, Jesus has gone to Gethsemane with his disciples, Peter, James, and John. Whilst in that Gethsemane with Jesus, where his disciples also, we have come with him to Gethsemane with our troubles, to be with our agonizing Jesus. And through his agony, through the sweat, turned blood from his body, our distress shall reach his consent tonight. Our tears shall reach the office of Jesus tonight. Holy Father, as we have come to this Gethsemane to be with you, Holy Father, remove every spirit of distraction, spirit of sleep. May we remain strong in prayer. May the full merits of this prayer be received in the name of Jesus. Almighty and eternal Father, accept our prayers of thanksgiving for your beloved Son who went into Gethsemane for the love of his people. As we recall his sacred passion, send the Spirit of Christ into our hearts, we ask you, O Lord, so that whether we pray or walk, we might do all in union with Christ, our Redeemer. This and many more we pray. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Jesus, you are ready. I can see your presence. You are ready. All we can do is to open up our hearts for him already here. My Jesus, oh Jesus, you are ready. We can see your presence. You are ready. All we can do is to open up our hearts. For you is already here. Amen.
The first station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because from your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Mark chapter 14, verse 61 to 64 says, and the high priest began to ask him and said to him, are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One? And Jesus said to him, I am, and you shall see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven. But the high priest tore his garments and said, what further need have we of witnesses? You have heard the blasphemy. What do you think? And they all condemned him as liable to death. My dear children, in this session, I bring to your notice that I was condemned. But even though I was condemned, but my Father did not condemn me. And so their condemnation could not stand. When you put your trust in me, it does not matter how many voices that are condemning you. I am your Lord, your Savior, who sets you free. when you are sentenced to condemnation. And so, seek my face. In everything you go through, seek my face. When the enemy condemns you, seek my face. When you seek my face, you will find favor. You will find not only my presence, but also my peace. To receive my peace, you must change your grasping. You must change the way you look at things. You must learn to trust in me. The only thing you can grasp without damaging your soul is my hand. When you are condemned, who lift your hand and I will hold you. I will pull you out from the pit of condemnation. Remember that my son and servant Jeremiah was condemned by enemies and they put him in a pit. But while in the pit of condemnation, he was praying and I answered him. I want to do the same in your life. Whatever is a pit of condemnation that the enemy has sentenced you to, trust me. Let that pit become a pulpit for you. I will answer you. I will deliver you. I will give you peace in your times of trouble. Trust me. Ask my spirit within you to order your day and control your thoughts. For the mind controlled by my spirit is life and peace. It is your heritage to have the peace that I give to those who love me. You can have as much as me and my peace as you want through thousands of correct choices each day. The most persistent choice you face is whether to trust me or to worry. Many sometimes choose to worry. They choose to listen to the enemy. And so they start to sink like Peter. Peter was worried about the storm. Fear came into him. And he started to sink. But that was a choice he made. My dear children, I love you. And I want you to trust me. Do not choose worry. Worry is not good for you. Why worry when I'm with you? Why worry when I can take care of that situation? Hand it over to me and see what I will do. You will never run out of things to worry about. Do you know that? But you can choose to trust me no matter what. I am an ever-present help in trouble. That is my name. Trust me. Though the world give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, trust me. Holy Father, we thank you for talking to us in this first session to seek your face and to listen to your voice and never to listen to the voice of the enemy. Never to listen to the voice of condemnation. Father, we thank you that even when the enemy comes with their voices, Father, from today, we receive the grace to listen to your voice. Holy Father, as David, on hearing the voice of Goliath, could not listen to Goliath, but listen to your own voice, and therefore was victorious. May we, O Lord, continue to listen to you and rejecting the voice of the enemy. Help us, O Lord, for by seeking your face, no condemnation shall stand against us. For whoever you have predestined, you justify. For those whom you justify, you also glorify. According to Romans 8 verse 30. Holy Father, may you justify your people tonight. And may you bring glory to your name in my life and in my family. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Jesus is passing this way, this way, this way. Jesus is passing this way, he's passing this way tonight. Oh, my Lord is passing your way this way. Jesus is passing this way, he's passing this way right now. Amen.
The second station, Jesus carries his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
John 19 verse 14 to 17 says, and Pilate said to the Jews, behold your king. But they cried out, away with him, away with him, crucify him. Pilate said to them, shall I crucify your king? The chief priests answered, we have no king but Caesar. Then he handed him over to them to be crucified. And so they took Jesus and led him away, bearing the cross for himself. Yes. My dear children, I bore the cross for myself. The weight of the cross was on my shoulders, bruising my shoulders, peeling my skin. I carried a cross that the whole world could not carry. I carried a cross that you may have peace. I took that cross that you may have rest. My dear children, I want to teach you a mystery. There is rest in the cross. There is peace in the cross. There is a way in the cross. When I carried the cross, the multitude followed me. They did not accept me to be the way. But because I carried the cross and they followed me behind, that way, I have become their way, and they were following me. In your troubles, there is a solution in the cross. In your crisis, there is a solution in the cross. There is life in the cross. There is a hope in the cross. There is a joy in the cross. Yet, the world has rejected the cross. But you are not of the world. I have called you out of the world. Therefore, embrace the cross. I embrace the cross. Take up your cross and follow me. Come to me and rest. I am all around you to bless you and to restore you. I have my plans for you. I know that the cross is heavy. I carried it before you, but I will help you to carry it. I called you to carry the cross, but I've made provisions for grace to carry the cross. Why are my children rejecting the cross? Why are my people longing for heaven, but they don't want to carry the cross? My children, carry the cross and follow me. Each day, there is a cross I have kept for you. But I cannot give you a cross that you cannot carry. I cannot allow it to come to you. I give you a cross that is commensurate with your strength and grace. Breathe me in with each breath. And I will give you grace to make the journey. You don't know the way ahead. I know the way ahead. I am the way. The way just ahead of you is very steep. There are dangers on the road, but you don't know. But many of my children are running away from me, running into dangerous terrain. Slow down. Slow down. Hold my hands and walk with my pace. Don't slip yourself out of my hands that you can walk faster or run faster. When you hold my hands, you cannot walk slower or faster, because you yield to me and listen to me, and I direct your footsteps. Slow down. Slow down. The world sees strength on those who are traveling on the fast lane. The way of the world is a fast lane. Everybody is impatient. They want to make it fast. They want to get to the destination fast. They want to do it the fast way. They do it, but lose the joy of salvation. But my children are on the lane of life. The world might say you are sluggish, but don't listen to the world. Listen to me. Take the cross. You cannot carry the cross and be on the fast lane. When you reject your cross, then you can be on a fast lane. That way you become of the world. But when you carry the cross, then you walk at my pace. You walk at this slow path, but steady. Slow and steady wins the race. Carry the cross. The road is narrow, windy, full of thorns, but there's life in it. Do not change lane to the fast lane. Walk with me. My hand will hold you. I am teaching you a difficult lesson. Yes, I am teaching you a difficult lesson that is learned only by hardship, only by carrying the cross. But there's life in it. When you are passing through difficulties, I know you are passing through difficulties. I see your pains. But trust me. Bring those troubles to me. Offer them to me. Offer your troubles to me. Offer your hardships to me. Offer your tears to me. Don't allow those pains to waste away. When you are in pains, or you are in suffering, or in hardship, and you do not offer them to me, you are wasting that opportunity. Offer them to me. I will turn the pains to gains. I will turn the hardships to glory. I will turn that mess to message. But only when you offer them to me. Now, from today, I want you to offer your pains, your disappointments, your betrayals to me. Offer them to me. Allow me to do whatever I will with it. You will like it. Lift up empty hands of faith to receive my precious presence. Lift up your hands of faith to receive my cross. Light, life, joy, and peace flow freely from the cross. That is my gift to you. When your focus turns away from me, you grasp for other things. You grasp for the world. But how can you grasp things that has no value, that has no essence? You drop the glowing candle I've given to you when you drop the cross, when you reject the cross. Don't seek the lifeless ashes, for this is what you do when you drop the cross. Return to me. Regain my presence. I am your Lord Jesus, present in the Blessed Sacrament, waiting for my people to come, that I may give them rest. Jesus. Father, we thank you that you have carried the cross and have invited us to carry the cross and have given us the grace to carry the cross and follow you. Father, as you give us the grace, may this grace be sufficient, O Lord. May we find rest in the cross. May we find hope, blessings, restoration in the cross. In our hardships, may we learn to offer them to you, Lord. Holy Father, help us. Strengthen us, O Lord. Give us a new dimension to the cross, so that from today, we do not run away from the cross, but we receive the cross. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master. Prayer is the key. Oh, Jesus began with prayers, ended in prayers. Prayer is the master. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master. Prayer is the key. Jesus began with prayers. He ended in prayers. Prayer is the master. Prayer is the key. Amen.
The third station. Jesus falls the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
John chapter 15, verse 18 to 20 says, if the world hates you, know that it has hated me before you. If you were of the world would love what is its own. But because you're not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hates you. Remember the word that I have spoken to you. No servant is greater than his master. If they have persecuted me, they will also persecute you. Come to me, my children. I know you are persecuted because of me. I know the world had already rejected you on my own account. I know that the blows I have received, that the enemy is also targeting you. You have become a victim because of me. But my children, allow me to handle that matter. I carried your cross, and as I carried the cross, I fell on the ground. As you carry your cross, you will also fall down someday. But do not lose hope. Come to me for rest. When you fall, you need a refreshment. You need to be recharged. You know how to start your cars when they cannot start. You get another battery to refresh the old battery, to refresh the weak battery. You call it jumpstarting. I want to jumpstart you. Connect yourself to me through my Holy Spirit, and I will jumpstart you. Many of my children have fallen, and they have parked by the road like a car that has packed up without a battery. They are broken down. When you fall, you are like that car that has been parked by the road. But the owner of the car goes to look for a mechanic to help him to start the car and put it back to the road. I want to do the same in your life. I made you. So when you are sick, when you have fallen, when things are not going the way it's supposed to go, you should go to who made you. The car will be taken to the mechanic because the mechanic understands the car and knows the car about the car. But I made you. I want to fix your broken life. Yes. When you fall, you may have been broken. You may have become battered. You may have become shattered. But I want to fix your life. Even when you fall, it is a moment for refreshment. It is a moment to recharge you. It is a moment to jumpstart you and put you back to the road of life, the way of life. Come to me for rest and for refreshment. Falling is not a taboo. Falling is not bad. You live in a fallen world. The journey has been too much for you, and you are weary, and now has fallen. But do not be ashamed of your exhaustion. Instead, see it as an opportunity for me to take charge of your life. But many of my children make mistakes. When they fall, they try to pretend that they are strong. They pretend they don't face the reality. They want to show the world that they cannot fall. They want to show the world that they are strong. And when you try to do that, you miss the lesson why I allowed you to fall. My dear children, remember that I am your God. I can make something out of nothing. I can make strength out of weakness. Do you know that? I can fit anything into a pattern for good. So even when you think life is not treating you well, and you think it is over, and you think you have been broken into pieces, that becomes opportunity, and the very reason why you should seek me. Because I want to fix your broken lives. Many of my children, when they are broken, they even get more broken because they don't seek me. I want to help you. When you fall, remember me. Remember what I'm talking to you today. Bring your children to me. Bring your worries to me. Those things that are making you to fall, bring them to me. And trust me, I will make lemonade out of the lemon. I will make honey out of the bitterness. I will bring testimony out of your crisis. My dear children, from today, learn to trust me when you fall. Don't brood over the past mistakes you have made. Do not waste your time wishing you were different, or that you were created different, or that you had a different parent, or you grew in a different country. Don't wish those things. The world thinks so. I don't need those things before I bring my blessing to you. When the rain is falling, I send it both for the good and to the evil. The blessings you receive is not because of your goodness. I am good by nature. Start with where you are at this point in time and the space, accepting that this is where I intend you to be. It may not make meaning now, but bring that situation to me. You will get through today one step at a time, one moment at a time. Step by step, we shall walk together and we shall celebrate together. Your main responsibility is to remain attentive to me, is to trust me, is to allow me to guide you through the many choices along your pathway. This sounds like an easy assignment, right? But it is not. Your desire to live in my presence goes against the desire of the flesh. It goes against the desire of the world. It goes against the grain of the world. It goes against the wishes of the devil. But I will help you. My son, Paul, wanted to do the assignment. He wanted to carry his cross. He wanted to do it with every strength in his bones. But he found out that he could not. And I told him the secret. My grace is sufficient for him. The same for you. Maybe you are bone weary. Maybe you feel rejected. Maybe you feel abandoned. You are full of resentment. Bring them to me. Sometimes my children, when they start having problems, I start calling them. I start giving them signs. I speak to them in dreams and in visions. I speak to them in so many ways that they want to handle it their way. I tell them, leave me, bring this matter to me, leave it for me. They continue to do it their way until they come to the point that they cannot go further. At that point, they are completely broken. Completely broken. This was the experience of my son, Paul. Until I stood on his way to Damascus and took his sight away from him. Then he was able to yield to me. Do not allow me to take your sight away. Do not allow me to break your bones before you will hear me and obey me. Listen to me, my children. Much of your weariness results from your constant battle against these opponents, against the enemies yourself. I want to be the one to battle them, but you want to fight. By strength shall no man prevail. Choose me today. Choose my cross. And when you fall, I will help you to get up. But don't give up. Hope in me. For you will again praise me for the help of my presence. Jesus.
We are crew.
We give you all the glory for speaking to us in this third session. Even where we have fallen and become bone weary, Father, may you recharge us. May you refresh us. May you give us hope again. May you jumpstart us and put us back to the road that leads to life. As many that are carrying the cross and falling, Father, may your grace be sufficient. Help us, Lord, to carry our crosses and follow you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen.
Amen. We are crucified with Christ. We no longer live. Jesus Christ now lives in us. We are crucified with Christ. We no longer live. Jesus Christ now lives in us. Amen.
The fourth station. Jesus meets his afflicted mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
John chapter 19, verse 25 to 27 says, now there we are standing by the cross of Jesus, his mother and his mother's sister, Mary of Cleopas and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by, he said to his mother, behold your son. And then he said to the disciple, behold your mother. And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. My dear children, my mother was afflicted. My mother had so many problems in her heart because of the way the world rejected me, abused me, and brought injustice to me. But my mother continued to trust the will of God. My mother knew that I'm above all things. She saw the will of God in what I was passing through. My dear children, in your troubles, always know that I am above all things. I am above the troubles. I'm above the pains. I'm above the things that are harassing your life. I do not change. Although the world is changing, although your troubles are changing, but I am not changing. When you are afflicted, when you are surrounded by the lions, by the wolves, by the storm of life, learn to do what my mother did. My mother focused her attention on me. In spite of the problems, in spite of the pains in her heart, in spite of the tears, she focused on me. She knew I am above all things. Focus on me in your seasons of affliction. Seek my face. Behold my face. When you behold my face, you will rise above circumstances. This is the way of peace. So many people do not know that even in their crisis, there could be peace. That is true. There is peace, but only if I am allowed to come in. Peace is not the absence of troubles. The world sees peace as the absence of troubles. But I do not see peace as the world sees peace. Peace is my presence. And so you may have problems, you may have troubles, you may be afflicted, you may be in fire, but you can still have peace because of me. Have you asked yourself why Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, while in the fire, were praising me? They were supposed to be crying. They were supposed to be in pains there. But while in the fire, they were praising me. Because I was there with them. Give me a chance to be with you in that your trouble, and I will help you. Live in the light of my presence. I guarantee you that you will always have problems in this world. Yes, you will always have problems in the world. I told you this before. I told you, in the world, there are so many troubles. But be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. I have already told you this in John 16, verse 33. And I'm reminding you tonight, trust me. In the world, there's no guarantee that you will not experience troubles and problems. But I guarantee peace in your troubles. I guarantee to be with you to the end of age. I guarantee that storm will not take you. They will not carry you. That flood will not carry you away. I was with Noah, yet there was flood. Even though the world was everywhere flooded, but I made a provision for Noah. Whatever is a flood you are passing through, all you need is my presence and trusting in me. I guarantee, if you trust me, that flood will not carry you away. That problem will not carry you away. Focus on me. When you feel yourself sinking in the sea of circumstances, all I need from you is to do what Peter did. Help me, Jesus. And I will come. I will come. And I will draw you out of that miry waters. I will draw you back to me. I will not allow you to be drowned, nor to be scorched by the fire. If you have to say that 1,000 times daily, that is not too much. Help me. Don't be discouraged. Trust me. I know your weaknesses, and I know you are weak. But I will meet you at your point of weakness to help you. Amen. Jesus. Holy Father, we thank you, Holy Father God, for speaking to us once more. That even when we are afflicted, you have given us a formula to keep going. And that is to trust you, to continue to seek your face, to reject the voices of the enemies. Father, help us. Even when we are sinking, help us. In our troubles, help us. Help us to trust in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Calvary, 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 I will not forget Calvary. Calvary, 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 oh Calvary, I will not forget Calvary, 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 we will not forget Calvary. Amen.
And that brings us to the fifth session. Simon of Cyrene helped Jesus to carry the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because of your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Mark chapter 15, verse 20 to 22 says, and when they had mocked Jesus, they took the purple cloak off and put his own clothes on him. And they led him out to be crucified. Then they forced a certain passerby, Simon of Cyrene, coming from the country, to take up his cross. They brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, a name meaning the place of his call. My dear children, the enemy had destined me for a place of the skull, a land of the dead, a land of no return. I was in anguish, but I found none to comfort me. My dear children, as you carry your cross, I have a message for you that I will help you. Simon helped me. I will also help you by providing my grace for you. Always know that I will never leave you. I have said it before, and I will say it again. Because I want you to know the truth. And that is to seek my face. When the cross is heavy, lift your face and seek me. And I will help you. By looking at my face, you will receive strength. You will receive grace. Seek my face the more. The more you fall, the more you should seek my face. To be intimate with me, you have to carry the cross. You cannot be intimate with me without being like me. I am a man of the cross. You have to be a son, a child, a daughter of the cross. You have to be a client of the cross. Did I not tell you to carry your cross and follow me? Do you know why I said that? Because in the cross, there is life, there is way. You cannot have an intimacy without carrying the cross. You have to come to me carrying your cross and helping others, encouraging others. Sometimes I would like to use you to encourage your neighbor who is struggling with his own cross. This is my message for you, my children. You are really just beginning your journey of intimacy with me. But sometimes you get weary, you fall, you get up, you get weary, you fall, and the such cycles continues. But that is the beauty of a journey with me. And that is the play I want to play with you. It is a journey of the cross. The relationship between you and me makes meaning when you carry the cross. The cross is what I want you to carry. Do not reject the cross. It is not an easy road, but it is a delightful and a privileged way. The world has not found the treasure in the cross, but you are not of the world. And I want to reveal to you the treasure in the cross. Trust me. Hardships are part of the journey too. You carry the cross, you feel the burden. But that's part of the journey. My dear children, I will never allow the cross to crush you. I allow certain measure of the cross that is just the right dosage that you're able to bear. I allow that with love, with tenderness. You cannot imagine the love I have for you. Do you know that the love I have for you is in the cross? Do not recoil from carrying the cross. Do not recoil when I allow certain afflictions to come, because by those afflictions I purify you, make you a vessel for the master's use. I am the master. There is no beauty in the cross to behold from the perspective of the world. But this is the beauty in your soul, is the beauty of the cross. Do not reject the cross. I will help you to carry the cross. It is a gift from me to you. The cross, receive it, and I will help you. The cross is a magnet. It magnetizes glory, grace, strength, testimonies. Everything good coming from the kingdom of my Father. But you know what? They come through the cross. I gave you life through the cross. The cross was the instrument I used to give you life. The instrument to open your doors The cross is the key to open the doors. Receive your cross. Trust me as you carry the cross. And don't be afraid, for I am your strength and I'm your song. Jesus. Father, we thank you for ministering to us in this fifth session, promising to help us with your grace to carry the cross, even as Simon helped to carry the cross. Father, help us, Lord, to see intimacy in the cross, love in the cross, to see delight in the cross. Father, you told us that the road is not easy. It is not an easy one. But you also told us that it is a delightful and a privileged way. Father, help us to see the treasure in the cross and go for it. Holy Father, do not allow us to drop our cross. Help us to help each other. Those who are losing courage, Father, help us to help them to carry their cross by giving them encouragement, by praying for them. In Jesus' super mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Mm. And amen.
Oh, merciful Jesus. Oh, merciful Jesus. Oh, merciful Jesus. That he will trust in you. Oh, merciful Jesus. Oh, merciful Jesus. Oh, merciful Redeemer, that we trust in you. Amen.
The sixth session. Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Matthew chapter 25, verse 37 to 40 says, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? And when did we see you a stranger and take you in, or naked and clothe you? Or when did we see you sick or in a prison and come to you? And answering, the king will say to them, Amen, I say to you, as long as you did it for one of these, the least of my brethren, you did it for me. Jesus. My dear children, the world rejected me. The world disfigured me with their blows. They used me for punching bag. My face was swollen. Those who knew me could not know me again. I was disfigured by injustice. I was humiliated by the hands of my own brothers. My own people rejected me. My face was swollen by the blows I received from the hands of those I came to save. But in the midst of all this, where my beauty was hidden in blood, in a smear of blood, and where no one offered to help or to be identified with me, for I was totally rejected. There, a soul, a beautiful soul, pushed through the crowd, elbowed her way through the crowd, and came to me. Her name is Veronica. Veronica, wipe my face. Veronica, wipe my bloodied face. Veronica, help me in my time of need. Veronica, had a time with me when I was rejected. And that was like finding a cup of cool water in the hot desert. I want you to spend time with me, no matter how small. The little time that Veronica spent with me when I was humiliated, when I was suffering, it was a great opportunity for me to bless her life. I gave her my face. She gave me her handkerchief. I gave her my holy face. If you trust me and you come to me even to spend a little time with me during the day, I will also give you my face. There is great joy in my mind when I see you come to me in prayer to have a small time with me. I'm not even demanding so much from you. I gave you 24 hours of the day, but I'm not demanding a fraction of it. In what way have I demanded so much? Am I unfair to demand just a little? Just a fraction out of the 24 hours I gave to you? As simple as this sick looks like, yet my children have no time for me. They get up from the bed hurriedly, dress up, and go for the day's work. Come back exhausted and lie down on the bed. And the cycle continues. No time to say thank you. Not even a thank you. I want to see my children have time with me. Even if it is a little time. It blesses me. It also blesses you. Both of us get blessed when you have a quality time with me. Switch off your cell phones. Shut the world out of your life and create a small space for you and for me. I love it. Then I will speak to you. Then you will hear my voice. Trust me enough to spend that time with me, pushing back the demands of the world like Veronica. Veronica was in the midst of the people who were demanding for my life. But Veronica elbowed her way through and came to me and had a small quality time with me. My dear children, refuse to be so busy that you cannot have time again with me. Refuse to feel guilty about something that is so pleasing to me that you did not do. All I want you is to start afresh today. Because I am omnipotent, I am able to bend time and event in your favor. Your day may be busy, your calendar may be busy, but when you ask me to help you to create time, I will help you. I want that quality time with you. Make time. I want to bless you. When you make time with me, then you can now be able to hear my voice. My children, I want to tell you a story. Once upon a time, a farmer lost his watch, an expensive watch in the farm. He looked for it all day, no way. He ransacked the farm. He could not find his expensive watch. One day, when he gave up, he called little children to help him to look for the watch. And the little children were scampering everywhere in the farm looking for the watch. And they were playing everywhere in the farm. The farmer thought that by the children playing, they were able to see it. But they could not. Then one of the children said, "Papa, give me a little time. Let me go back and search for the watch." And I told him, he said, "My son, go." And in a little while, the little boy came back with a watch. And he said, "Wow, where did you find it?" Little boy said, "I just found it there. It wasn't even much hidden." "How did you find it?" "I had to put my ears on the ground. And I was silent, I was quiet, and I heard the ticking hand of the clock. Tam, tam, tam. I heard it, and I knew that the clock was nearby." My dear children, there are some voices I'm speaking to you. I have been speaking to you, but because you are busy, your mind is busy, you cannot hear my voice. If you do what that little boy did, to put your ears silently in a place of seclusion where I will meet you, and there you will hear my voice. Make a time for me. I will bless every time you give to me. Do you know that when you come to the prayer line to pray, I bless your time? This time you spend here, you don't go back the same. I bless you for making time with me. You will find out that time with me is never a wasted time. You will find out that you can accomplish more in less time when you offer your time to me. As you align yourself with my perspective, you can sort out what is important and what is not. Spend your time with me. I went to the house of Mary and Martha. Martha was busy with the kitchen. But Mary listened to my words, and she was blessed. She made a better choice. Would you make a better choice today, my child? I have messages to give to you. I have things to tell you. Blessings that are coming and things for you to do. Dangers that are ahead and what to do to avert it. I talk to you, sometimes I'll be screaming, but you don't hear me. Because your heart is crowded with voices of the world. Don't fall into the trap of being constantly on the go, of being constantly on the move. Many, many, many people have entered into danger because they are constantly on the move, having no value for the kingdom, no time for the kingdom of God. To avoid being meaningless, spend your time with me. Stay in continual communication with me in prayer. I will instruct you and I will teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eyes upon you. Holy Father, we thank you for blessing the life of Veronica when she used her little time and her handkerchief to offer to you. Father, as we spend time with you, may you give us that divine exchange to give us your holy face, to deliver us from bondage. Father, teach us the wisdom in having time with you, a quality time with you. For you have taught us that when we offer our time to you, then you will help us to have a better and a more efficient use of our day. In other words, spending time with you is a way to live the day smarter. Father, may we be smarter by making that choice today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
He loves me. I cannot say why. He loves me. I cannot say why. On the Calvary tree, he was crucified. He loves us. We cannot say why. Jesus loves us. We cannot say why. He loves us. We cannot say why. Say why. On the Calvary tree, he was crucified. He loves us. We cannot say why. Lord, I want to be like Jesus in my heart. Lord, we want to be like Jesus in our heart, in our heart, in my soul. Lord, I want to be like Jesus in my heart. Amen.
The seventh station. Jesus falls the second time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Isaiah chapter 53, verse 4 to 6 says, it was our weaknesses that he carried, our sufferings that he endured, while we thought of him as stricken, as one struck by God and afflicted. But he was pierced for our offenses, and the cross for our sins. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole. By his stripes, we were healed. We have all gone astray like sheep, each following his own way. But the Lord laid upon him the guilt of us all. My dear children, I bore the punishment of the world. I lived in pains that you may be free. Upon me was the punishment that makes you whole. And by my stripes you are healed. Looking at me on that fateful day, you see a wounded man. But I was wounded that you be healed. My dear children, in this my second fall, I want to encourage you to be strong. My peace is like a shaft of golden light shining on you continuously, even when you fall. that light will continue to fall on you, shine on you. Do not think that when you fall, it is a sign that my light has gone out of you. No. You are the apple of my eyes. During days of bright sunshine, it may that light may blend in with your surrounding. On darker days, my light stands out in sharp contrast to your circumstances. See times of darkness, times of falling, as opportunities for my light to shine in transcendent splendor. I am training you to practice peace that overpowers darkness. The part of that training requires you to fall. Collaborate with me in this training, and I will make you strong. Do not grow weary, and do not lose heart. Our Lord Jesus, in this second fall, we bring ourselves to you. We pray, Father, may your light continue to shine upon us. You are the light of the world, and you are the light of our souls. Whatever thing that is knocking us down, Father, help us by your light to see it. May we never grope in darkness. For those who grope in darkness will fall into the pit or the trap of the enemy. Holy Father, in times of darkness, may your light shine the more. Help us to collaborate with you when you train us on how to carry the cross. May we never lose heart. May we never grow weary. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. Super power, mighty power, there is power in the blood. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. There is power, healing power, there is power in the blood. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. Amen.
The eighth station. Jesus meets the woman of Jerusalem. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Luke chapter 23, verse 27 to 28 says, there was following Jesus a great crowd of people, and among them were some women who were bewailing and lamenting him. Jesus, turning to them, said, daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children. My dear children, as I was carrying the cross, some women saw me, and they were heartbroken, and they started to weep. They started to lament. I want to tell you something, my dear friends. As I was near to this woman that day, so I am near to you. It was when I came close to the woman that they saw how battered I was. They saw the wounds on my body. They saw the blood everywhere. They saw the cross. They saw the crown of thorns. They saw how I was looking frail, staggering. And they started to cry. From far, they could not see that. But when I came close, they saw my anguish. Do you know that as I came to those women, I was near to them, so I am near to you. I'm near to your brokenheartedness. I hover over you. I hover over your shoulder. I read your thoughts. People think that thoughts are fleeting and worthless. But yours are precious to me. I smile when you think lovingly of me. My spirit, who lives within you, helps you to think my thoughts. By your thinking goes, and as your thinking goes, so goes your entire being. These women, they had the thoughts of compassion on me, thoughts of mercy on me. And I spoke to them the words of mercy and compassion. I told them they need to pray for themselves and for their children. How many times do you pray for your children? How many times do you pray for the children of the world? How many times do you pray? The world is a place that needs prayer. As these women focused on me, so I encourage you this night to focus on me. Let me be your focus. I will wipe your tears. These women came to me with their tears. Come to me with yours. When you look to me, knowing me as your God who is with you, who can never abandon you, then you experience joy. Do you see the secret of joy? It is all about focusing on me, even when troubles are there. This is according to my will. When I created you, I made you to depend on me, to bring your troubles to me, because I know you cannot do it on your own. Modern man seeks his positive focus elsewhere, in sports, in sensations, in acquisition of new possessions. Modern man has gone to seek focus, pleasure in the world at the expense of his soul. Those who seek pleasure, those who seek the companion of the world, they do so at the expense of their soul. And they are vulnerable. The little things will blow them away. But those who put their trust in me are like Mount Zion. The storm comes, but they are strong. They are rooted in me. And their tap root is in me. Nothing can take them away from me. My child. My children. I love you. I love you. I put in your heart a longing for me. When troubles come, it is opportunity for you to seek me, to long for me. These women, they were longing for me. And they came to me. You haven't come to me. Many of my children run away from me. Many accuse me that I'm responsible for their troubles. How can I, your loving God, be the one that is causing your problems and troubles? Bring your problems to me. I planted in your heart a longing for me, knowing that only I could satisfy you. Delight yourself in me, and let me become the desire of your heart. Jesus. Holy Father, as these holy women, as these women of Jerusalem left their problems, brought their tears to you, and sought your companion, may we do likewise, O God. Holy Father, you read their minds, you saw their thoughts, and you addressed them. Father, see our thoughts. We cannot even hide them from you. For even when we run to the bottom of the sea, even there, we cannot hide from you. Even when we run to the darkness, the world of darkness, there's no darkness before you. Father, our thoughts cannot be hidden from you. Holy Father, teach us how to have holy thoughts that bring glory of you, to think of you all the time, to think of companionship with you. Father, help us. Father, we are addicted to sports, to sensations, to acquisition of new possessions, acquisition of diplomas and accolades. But Father, help us that we may not focus on all this, but from today, to begin to focus on you. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Miracle worker. Come and do a miracle. A miracle today. Come and do a miracle. A miracle tonight. Oh, destiny changer. O powerful healer, O come and do a miracle, O miracle today. Come and do a miracle, O miracle tonight. Your name is Yahweh, your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle-working God. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle-working God. Your name is Yahweh. Amen.
And that brings us to the ninth station. Jesus falls the third time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Psalm 118, verse 25 to 28 says, I lie prostrate on the dust. Give me life according to your word. I declared my ways, and you answered me. Teach me your commands. Make me understand the way of your precepts, and I will meditate on your wondrous deeds. My soul with full sorrow, strengthen me with your words, O Lord. My children, I have fallen the third time. I want to tell you, my own children, congratulations. For even when you fall, I pour the water of my peace on you. Ever since the resurrection, I have always said it, peace be with you. And I'm here to say it again to you, peace be with you. My children, when you fall, always continue to remember that you are not alone. Remember that my radiant peace is available for you. Enfold yourself in my loving presence. to provide this radiant peace for you, I died a criminal's death. So your portion in this journey is just a small portion. You fall again, and you fall again. You cannot compare that with my death on the cross. But these little troubles you have received from me, that I have allowed that you may carry the cross, let it bring you closer to me. Many of my children would never have come to me if not for the troubles that came their way. Do you know that? Sometimes when the trouble comes, it's a bell ringing for my attention. My dear children, always remember that your fall is not lack of dignity. It is dignity. Because when you fall, I give you strength. It is a rare treasure. Dazzling in delicate beauty, yet strong enough to withhold all the onslaughts of the enemies. Wear my peace with regal dignity. It will keep your heart and your mind close to me, even when you fall. Jesus. Father, we thank you. In this third fall, we'll bring to you all the situations, all the storms, all the parameters of the enemies that are pushing us down, that are making us to fall. Father, help us to be strong and to continue to trust in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
All power belongs to Jesus. All power belongs to God. All power belongs to Jesus. No power can pull us apart. All power belongs to Jesus. All power belongs to my God. Every power belongs to Jesus. No power can pull us down. You are a miracle-working God. You are a miracle-working God. You are the Alpha and Omega. You are the miracle-working God. You are miracle-working God. You are the miracle-working God. You are the Alpha and Omega. You are the miracle-working God. Amen.
The tenth session, Jesus is stripped of his clothes. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Matthew chapter 27, verse 34 to 35 says, they gave Jesus wine to drink mixed with gall. But when he had tasted it, he would not drink. And then after they had crucified him, they divided his clothes, casting lots to fulfill what was spoken through the prophets. They divided my clothes among them, and upon my garments they cast lots. My dear children, the hands of my people have stripped me of my clothes. I allow them to take my clothes. I did not restrain them. So I do not expect you to restrain me from being fully in charge of your life. Give yourself fully to me. I allowed the governors, the executioners, to fully do all that they did. I gave my life on my own accord. Nobody forced me to do it. I did out of love for you. But how come my children have not given themselves fully to me? And so now on my children, I am the good shepherd, and the sheep hears my voice and it obey. You are my sheep. Give yourself fully to me. When you do that, then we can walk together. Walk boldly along the path of life, relying on my ever-present presence. I am your companion. The world may have taken away your garment, but I will wear you the garment of my glory. Have you been taken to shame? But I will take away your shame. I have been made naked, that you be clothed. When my clothes were taken away from me, it is a reminder to you that naked you came to the world, and naked you shall go. You have every reason to be confident in me, because my presence accompanies you all the days of your life, and even till eternity, and into eternity. Do not give in to fear or worry, because your business is stripped of its profit, or because your career is stripped of its of promotions. Do not fear. Bring that concern to me. Worry is a robber. Yes. Worry, fear, these are robbers of your abundant living. Have you not noticed that when you start worrying, when you start fearing, then you lose living. You lose the joy of life. What is that thing that you are passing through? You think I cannot do something about it? Trust me enough to face problems as they come, rather than trying to anticipate them. Job, my son, anticipated the problems and he came. What he feared came to him. What he was worried about came to him. Do not worry about tomorrow. Seek first my kingdom, and every other thing will be added unto you. Fix your eyes on me. I am the author and perfecter of your faith. And many difficulties on the road ahead will vanish before you even reach there, because you have allowed me as an equation in your life. Wherever you start to feel afraid, remember that I am holding you by your right hand. Nothing can separate you from my presence. Our Lord Jesus, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, we thank you for where the enemy meant to put us to shame by disrobing us of our honor, of our integrity, of our prayer life, of our relation with you. Father, even there, you put them to shame by clothing us with victory, clothing us with a crown, clothing us with righteousness. Father, have your way in us. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for you and your house, you will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord. We're praying together. We're carrying the cross together as for me and my house. We'll serve the Lord as for you and your house. You will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord. Amen.
The 11th session. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Luke chapter 23, verse 32 to 34, and John chapter 19, verse 18 says, when they came to Golgotha, the place called the place of the skull, they crucified Jesus and the robbers, one on his right and the other on his left. And Jesus said to them, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. My dear children, I have been crucified, I have been nailed to the cross. It was a painful experience for me, but I trusted the hands of my Father. I put myself in the hands of my Father. So I want you to put yourself in my hand. Come to me. I stretched my hand on the cross as I was nailed. But I stretched my hand that you may run to me to embrace me. I am your Father and I want to embrace you. Come to me with all your weakness, with all your problems, physical, emotional, spiritual. Rest in the comfort of my hands. Do you not see my hands spread apart to embrace you? Come on to me. I want to give you rest. Remember that nothing is impossible with me. If I have not allowed the enemies, they would not be able to nail me. But I saw the will of my Father in all this. And I allowed and offered myself to be nailed to the cross. And so do not fear. I am nailed for you to be free. Pry your mind away from your problems so you can focus your attention on me. Recall that I am able to do immeasurably more than able, more than all that you have ever asked or imagined. Instead of trying to direct me to do this and that, seek to tune yourself to my own frequency. Tune yourself to what I'm already doing. I tuned my life to the frequency of my Father. And that was why I accepted the nails. Because I saw the will of my Father in it. There are nails you have to accept because you have seen my will in it. When anxiety attempts to wage its way into your thoughts, remind yourself that I am your shepherd. The bottom line is that I am taking care of you. Therefore, you need not be afraid of anything. Rather than trying to maintain control over your life, abandon yourself to my will, just like I abandoned myself to my Father. Though this may feel frightening, even dangerous, but the safest place to be is actually in my hands and in my will. And you find favor and strength from me. Father, we thank you. Even in this session where you are nailed, we bring to you, O Lord, all the situations that have nailed us down. Father, O Lord, by your power, may you set us free. For in John 8, verse 36, your word said that whosoever the Son of Man sets free is free indeed. Father, many of your people are nailed to the tree of poverty, to the tree of barrenness, to the tree of miscarriage, to the tree of crisis. Father, deliver them today, O Lord. That family that is stormy, Father, bring peace in that family. Remove that nail. People that in their lives, there are nails in their body, spiritual nails. Cancer is a nail. That fibroid is a nail. May Jesus uproot them from your life tonight in the name of Jesus. May he bless you in the name of the Father. May he take away your shame in the name of the Son. May he uproot those nails in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Over and over, over and again. Over and again, I give you my life. Over and again, and over and again, I belong to you. Over and again, I give you my life. Over and again, we give you our lives. Over and again, and over and again, we belong to you. Amen.
The 12th session. Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Shall we be on our knees? Luke chapter 23, verse 44 to 46 says, it was now about the 6th hour, and there was darkness all over the whole world until the 9th hour, and the sun was darkened, and the curtain of the temple was torn in the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice and said, it is finished. Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. Then bowing his head, he died. At this hour, my dear friends, let us talk to the Lord about our problems. Let us pour our hearts to him. The blood is flowing from the side of Jesus. That is the divine mercy, blood and water. The blood is flowing from the hands and the feet and the body of Jesus. May that blood locate you wherever place you are. May that blood uproot everything that is not planted by the Lord in your life. May the Lord Jesus touch you at this hour. I pray against every spirit of bondage, people that are suffering from collective captivity. May Jesus locate you at this hour. May Jesus locate you at this hour. May healing flow. May healing flow. Let healing flow. Let healing flow. Let healing flow. We are the feet of Jesus. We are at Jesus' clinic. This is Jesus' clinic. Healing is flowing from the clinic. Healing is flowing from the clinic. Receive that healing power. Let the healing power of Jesus touch you. Jesus, Jesus, ask him to touch you now. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 22, and the Bible says, is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is there no healing for the wounds of my people? But now that question is getting an answer now, because Jesus is healing you. Talk to him about your situation. Talk to him now. Talk to him now. The Bible says that I will restore your health. Talk to him now. What do you want him to restore? As you are talking to him, we invite our sister to offer songs at this hour. Jesus.
The blood of Jesus set me free. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus set us free. Oh, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus set us free. From sin and sorrow, the blood of Jesus set us free. The blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus set us free. From sin and sorrow, the blood of Jesus set us free. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power, healing power in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power, there is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power, mighty power in the blood. Amen.
The 13th station. The body of Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise thee.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
John chapter 19, verse 33 to 34 says, when the soldiers came to Jesus, they saw that he was already dead, so that they did not break his legs. But one of them opened his side with a lance, and immediately there came out blood and water. And Joseph of Arimathea, because he was a disciple of Jesus, although a secret one for the fear of the Jews, besought Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus. And Pilate gave permission. My dear friends, in this very station, we are recalling that the blood and water that was coming out from the side of Jesus is for our healing. And may we be completely healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As Jesus was taken down from the cross, so may the heaven open and bring down upon us the miracles that we are believing God for. Jesus was on the cross, but now he has been taken down. Now he is nearer to us. Now he is not in the form that people could hold him. People can now touch him. On the cross, he was lifted up. But now, he who is afar is now reachable. I pray that you may reach him and touch him. By touching him, may every issue of blood in your life, every leaking syndrome in your life, be uprooted in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Dominara, nara to thee, Lord. Draws nearer to thee. Draw us closer, closer to thee, our Lord. draws closer, closer to thee. Oh Lord, our sons every day, Father, draw us closer to you. Draw us closer, closer to thee. I pray, our Lord, our sons every day, Daddy, draw me nearer to you. Draw us closer, closer to thee.
The 14th session, Jesus is laid in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Matthew chapter 27, verse 59 to 60 says, Joseph of Arimathea took the body of Jesus, and wrapping it in a clean linen cloth, he laid it in his new tomb, which he had hewn out of the rock. Then he rolled a large stone against the entrance of the tomb, and they departed. At this point, we bury our problems. We bury our disappointments. Declare all of them buried. That sickness, we bury them. We bury every setback in our life. We declare all of them buried. I don't know what is the story of your life, but bury them now. We lay them in the tomb with Jesus. Psalm 29 verse 6 says, at nightfall, weeping enters in, but joy at dawn cometh joy. May the joy of the morning Easter or Easter morning locate you and bless you. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Come and see what the Lord has done for us. Come and see what the Lord has done for us. Come and see, oh, what Jesus has done for us. If we were to be men, we will really pay. Come and see what our Lord has done for us. Come and see what our Lord has done for us. Come and see, oh, what Jesus has done for us. If we were to be men, we will really pay. We are saying, thank you, Jesus. We are saying, thank you, Jesus. We are saying, thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Daddy. Now forever. We are saying, thank you, my Lord. We are saying, thank you, Father. We are saying, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, now forever. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus, for all that you have done tonight, for blessing us, for being with us. Thank you for the answered prayers. We give you all the thanksgiving. We cover the blessings we received with the blood of Jesus, and we decree that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. And so we cover the prayers, blood of Jesus. We cover the sister that led us in songs with the blood of Jesus. And we cover our brother with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.